So next topic is a splicing of index number. See here. Splicing index number. So generally, as you know, that splice nothing but splicing a joint. Okay. For example, here, when you have the index numbers, for example, as we have taken just now, year 2010, 2017, old index numbers. For example, so there are some index numbers which are available up to one certain period only. After that, so we cannot get certain values. So here, generally, I'm going to say introduction about that splicing index number. So an old index series may be discontinued. What is a discontinued? For example, I'm going to take an example. Here 1995, so here you can take index number. Index number 100, 120, 160, 180, 200. The example here, the index number is available from 1995 to 1999. So later on, it is not available. And here, this is an old index number, old index number, and the new index number. So new index number is not available up to 1998, and here it will be available 100, 120, 140, 150, 160. For example, in order to measure the index value, so on the base of some years, they would calculate the index number up to 1999. So after 1999, so they have taken base year is another year. So therefore, the value will be changes. So here, so this is a discontinued. See, for example, if you observe this index value in this series, old index value. So there is a index values are available from 1995 to 1999. So after 1999, so the index values are not available. If you take into account new index values, here. There is no availability of index values from 1995 to 1998. After 1999, the index values are available. Here there is a discontinue. Here also there is a discontinue. Here discontinue. For example, why it could be happen? See, for example, when you're going to change the index value, the base years, for example, generally, for example, sometimes, for example, as per the index, for example, when you take GDP also. So the GDP value is available up to particular year. Then after, when you change the base year value, generally if you look at that GDP values, so they will data will be provided from 1995 to 2003, but they will mention clearly from 1995 to 1999 the GDP at base year is 2011 and 12 prices, for example. After 1999 to 2003, the GDP at prices on sudden they will mention the base year value, base year prices. Okay, so therefore there is a discontinued, nothing but discontinuation. So why it can be happen? Because of absolute items included in it or other reasons. For example, when you measure that index values, some items from 1995 to 99 also. For example, say after 1999, some other commodities also included in the index number. For example, when you are measuring the A item, B item, C item. For example, when you make your own family index number, for example. So what are the necessary items are there? They are included. For example, after 1999, disease has happened. For example, you need to spend some amount of money on medicals, nothing but medicines. So therefore, you may include that item also in that index number. So therefore, So there are some other reasons also there, not only base year. So there are other reasons also there to discontinue in the index values. So if a new series is constructed with discontinuation, for example, see here, new index number also constructed with the discontinuation year of the first as a base. The two series so obtained having a different bases are not comparable. For example, here see, index value is 100, 120, 160. If you take 100 and 120, if you compare this index value, this index value, it is meaningless because the base year changes. But the two series can be spliced together, nothing but the two series can be joined. That's called splice. That's the splicing of index number into a one series by multiplying and each index number of the new series by index number of the discontinued year of the old series. See here how we can multiply this old with new with old. See here there are two formulas are there. See first formula, see, for example, you go to right here. In order to splice that, so first formula. Splicing of old index to new index. So here the splicing of old to new. So when we are adding old to new, so the formula is, that is the old index into 100 divided by old index overlapping. This is a formula. And then another one. Splicing of new index to old index. Old to new to old. So that is new index formula. New index into old index overlapping by 100 divided by 100. So this is the formula. So here, for example, here old to new. For example, here why I am writing splicing of old index to new index. For example, here first we have the old index number and we don't have the year discontinued. We are there's a discontinued year. We have the new. First we need to know that old to new. So how we can calculate old to new? So here I am going to take an example, old to new. So here old index. For example, here also, how do you know that old index number and overlapping year? So here, for example, sometimes given the data, so they may ask the question, the overlapping year. So what is the overlapping year? Simple year, overlapping year, as you know that without giving also we need to identify overlapping year. See, this is the overlapping year. Because here only the data is changes, right? From onwards 1991, so the data is changes. So here, so old to new. So here you can write old to new. Or splicing of old to new. You can write splicing of old to new. Old to new, the formula. So old index is how much? Old index, how much value is there? Old index value in the year of 1995, the old index value is how much? 100 into 100 divided by what is there? And old index value into 100 divided by old index overlapping. Overlapping is how much here? Old index overlapping 200 is equal. So here you can cancel two zeros. 100 into 100 divided by 2 is equal. How much will get it? 50. All right. Then second one you can take here old index value 120 into 100 divided by old index overlapping. There is a 200 only. Here we can cancel two zeros. Then 120 by 2. How much? 60. 120 by 260. Then third one you can take as it is 160 into 100 divided by 200 is equal. You can cancel that two zeros. Then 160 divided by 2 is equal to how much? 80. Right? So then 180 into 100 divided by 200 is equal to 2 zeros can cancel. So 180 divided by 2 is equal to 90. Have you understood? Hello? So here see the old to new. So here the old to new. So this is a 50, 60, 80, 90. And again you can write this number. No problem. 100, 120, 140, 150, 160. See here, what did you understand by calculating this old to new? For example, if you take whatever we have taken here, the values as a base, if you take that base here, in order to construct that 1995 to 99, you will get like this, the values. Old to new. Have you understood? Hello?
Sir, overlapping means, sir?
Overlapping means, for example, where there is a the value, something for the index values are changes. For example, here, from 1995 to 1999, we have measured that index numbers values by taking some base years, right? Okay. So here, the index value is overlapping, nothing but here. This is a 200 year 100. Which one is right? See, as I mentioned that in 1999, index value is 200, and here also index value is 100. Which one is right? Sorry? We cannot say 100. That which is right. We cannot say which is right because, see, whatever they have measured here 100 and 200 is correct based on the their items as well as the base year prices. Here 100 is right, here 200 is right. But whatever they have taken the base year prices and whatever they have taken the base year prices about related to the 100 and 200 is right. For example, as I mentioned, for example, petrol prices on 2014 and 2018. If you compare, for example, if you take the data, for example, 2014, for example, here, 2014 lo 65 rupees. Okay, 2018 lo 85 rupees. 2021 lo only 103 rupees. For example, I'm assuming. For example, if you measure how much price increases from 14 to 21, how much it will be there? And average around 40% right?
Yes, sir.
So for example, if you compare 18 to 21, how much will be there?
30.
Around 20%, right?
Yes.
Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. For example, here, when you measure here 20%, around 20%, for example, here around 40%. For example, the 40% is right and 20% is right. Because which year they have taken base year? For example, they have taken base year is 20, here they have taken base year is 14. So like that, here also they have taken the different years and different data set, different items. So therefore, this is called overlapping year. Yes, still, I may answer your question. I think I have answered your question. Have you understood, sorry?
Yes, not understood, sir.
Still, overlapping means, for example, here 200 is right and 100 is right. But here the data is changing. See, the value index value changes. Why did you get 100 and why did you get 200? It's based on the base year. 200 is based on the its base year. And it is based on the its base year only. Or base year prices. So whatever others have you understood, still if you practice only you will get it. Sorry, and whatever others have you understood? Hello? What about others? Have you understood or not? Sharma?
Yes, sir, understood.
Okay. You can wait, Chari, sometimes, and after completion of this one, I will explain again also if you are not able to understand. Okay. Then, first we have calculated old to new. Old to new. Old to new. Then again, we need to calculate new to old. New to old. So here, new to old. For example, new to old, as data is old, right? Is there, na? So you can take the data 100, 120, 160, 180. And 200. Then from that there is a value will be changing. For example, see here I am going to say that yeah, see new to old, right? Sorry, new to old. So here new to old formula. What is the new to old? Old index value. Yeah, old index value into 100. The new index, sorry. New index into old index overlapping. Old index overlapping value. Overlapping value by 100. So what is the new index value here? You should have to take new index value. 100, right? Hello? So next, we need to take from here also, right? 3, 4 years, right? Yeah. We need to take here new index is 120. Okay, so here see I'm going to say 120 into old index overlapping. Old index overlapping how much? Overlapping old index. What is the 200 by 100 by 100. So therefore, see you can cancel the two zeros. 120 into 2, how much? 240 by 1 is equal. Then you can take this one. So this is the new index value 140, or else you can take this one also, no problem. 140 into old index overlapping, then the 200 divided by 100. You can cancel two zeros, then 240 into 2, 280 by 1 is equal to 280. Then here. So 150 into 200 divided by 100 is equal. If you cancel two zeros, you will get it 300 by 1 is equal to 300. So for this 160, you write 160 into 200 divided by 100. You can cancel two zeros. You will get 360 into 2. 320 by 1 is equal to 320. So this is the new to old. See, for example, if you observe these two, old to new and new to old. See, for example, if you follow old to new, the index values are this much, 50, 60, 80, 90, and up to 160. For example, if you had new to old, new to old, 100, 120, 160, 200, and 320. As you observe between these two, on average, it could be doubled. On average, it could be double. See, for example, old to new, 50 to 100, 60 to 120, 80 to 160, 90 to 180, 100 to 200, 120 to 240. So here, when you get the old to new, new to old, it is doubled, the answer is right. When you are going to check. Hello? Hello, dear students?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Is it understood or still anybody in the doubt?
That's good.